Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Today my presentation title is Environmental Pollution. Before presentation, little introduction about myself. I am Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. I have completed M.Sc. Agriculture with specialization Agronomy from JP Pant University of Agriculture and Technology, Pantnagar in 1996, and presently working as a seed professional in seed industry and associated with one of the MNC. So let's proceed to the presentation. What is pollution? Pollution is an undesirable change in the physical, chemical, or biological characteristics of air, water, and soil that may harmfully affect the life or create a potential health hazards of any living organism. Pollution is thus direct or indirect changes in any component of the biosphere that is harmful to the living components, and in particular undesirable for man, affecting adversely the industrial progress, cultural and natural assets, or general environment. What is pollutants? Any substance which causes pollution is called a pollutant. A pollutant may thus include any chemical or geochemical substances like dust, sediments, grit, and biotic components, or its product or physical factor that is released intentionally by man into the environment in such a concentration that may have adverse, harmful, or unpleasant effects. Now we'll study about environmental pollutants. The various principal pollutants which pollute our air, water, land are as follows, like deposited matter, having soot, smoke, tar, dust, grit, etc. Then gases, oxides of nitrogen, sulfur, carbon monoxides, and halogens. Then acid droplets like sulfuric acid, nitric acid. Then fluorides. Among metals, there are mercury, lead, iron, zinc, nickel, tin, cadmium, chromium. Then agrochemicals, where we are using the biocides like pesticides, herbicides, fungicides, nematicides, bactericides, weedicides, and fertilizers. After that, there are complex organic substances like benzene, ether, acetic acid, and there are some photochemical oxidants like photochemical smoke, ozone, peroxyacetylene nitrate, etc. After that, there are some solid wastes, radioactivates, and noise. So these are all the pollutants which are affecting the environment and health of human and living organisms. Now to study kinds of pollution. Various types of pollutants are classified in different ways. On the basis of the type of environment being polluted, we may recognize air pollution, water pollution, land soil pollution, noise pollution, radiation pollution, marine pollution, and thermal pollution. On the basis of the kind of pollutant involved, we may have sulfur dioxide pollution, fluoride pollution, carbon monoxide pollution, smoke pollution, lead pollution, mercury pollution, solid waste pollution, radioactive pollution, and noise pollution, etc. Pollutants are categorized in two types. First one is non-degradable pollutants. These are the materials and poisonous substances like aluminum cans, mercuric salts, long chain phenolics, DDT, etc. that either do not degrade or degrade only very slowly in nature. They are not cycled in ecosystem naturally, but by subsequent movement in food chains and by geochemical cycles. Second is biodegradable pollutants. They are the domestic wastes that can be rapidly decomposed under natural condition. They may create problems when they accumulate, where their input into the environment exceeds their decomposition. Now we'll study about biodegradable pollutants. These are categorized in three types. First one is primary pollutants. These includes those substances which are emitted directly from some identifiable sources. These include, first one is sulfur compounds like sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, and hydrogen sulfide produced by the oxidation of fuel. Second is carbon compounds like oxides of carbon, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, and hydrocarbons. Third is nitrogenous compound like nitrogen dioxide and ammonia. Fourth is halogen compounds like hydrogen fluoride, HF, and hydrochloric acid. Fifth is particles of different sizes and substances. These are found suspended in the air. The fine particles below the diameter of 100 microns are more abundant and include particles of metal, carbons, tar, pollen, fungi, bacteria, silicates, and others. And the second biodegradable pollutant is secondary pollutants. The secondary pollutants are produced by the combination of primary emitted pollutants in the atmosphere. In bright sunlight, a photochemical reaction occurs between nitrogen oxides, oxygen and waste hydrocarbons from gasoline that forms peroxystyl nitrate, PAN, and ozone. Both of them are toxic components of smog and cause smarting eyes and lung damage. After that, third biodegradable pollutant is smog. The fog deposited with smoke and chemical fumes forms a dark and thick covering the smoke. Smoke is very common in almost all the industrial areas, as the smoke is trapped for many days by the stagnant air. It is harmful both for animals and plants. Now to study about air pollution. It is defined as the excessive concentration of foreign materials in the atmosphere, which affects the health of individuals and also causes damage to the property. Certain substances may be any gas, liquid or solid. Although certain specific substances are considered significant pollutants because of very large emission rates or harmful and unwanted effects. Long enough durations can be anywhere from a few hours to several days or weeks. On a global scale, duration of months and years are of concern. Now, what are the sources of air pollution? Air pollution results from gaseous emission from mainly, first one is burning fossil fuels, industry, thermal power stations, emission from automobiles, domestic combustion, agricultural activities, wars, and natural causes. Here we will study about air pollutants criteria, effects of air pollution, and management of air pollution. First, air pollutants criteria. The five primary criteria pollutants include the gases, carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, sulfur dioxides, solid or liquid particulates, and particulate lead. And what are the effects of air pollution? First one is health effects. Second is effects on materials. Third, effect on plants, and effect on stratosphere. Then what are the management practices for air pollution control? First one is source correction. Second is collection of pollutants. Third is cooling of atmosphere. And fourth, treatment. Second pollution is water pollution. Water is extremely essential for life. This common fact is known to all. It is required to meet our basic needs in day-to-day life for cooking, drinking, bathing, disposal of sewage, irrigation, generating electricity in power plants, cooling and manufacturing different products in industries, and the disposal of industrial wastes. During all these processes, the undesirable substances are added to the water sources to a great extent. This alters the basic chemistry of water in rivers and streams and cause water pollution. What are the sources of water pollution? First one is domestic sewage. Second is industrial effluents. Third is agricultural sources. Fourth is pesticides. Fifth, thermal pollution. Sixth, pathogenic organisms. Seventh, mineral oils. Eighth, underground water pollution. And ninth, marine water pollution. Now to study control of water pollution. First one, separate ponds and tanks to be used for cattle and animals. Second, use of pesticides, insecticides and fertilizers should be done judiciously. Rapid biodegradable substitutes for pesticides should be employed. Third, in towns where sewage facilities are not available, septic tanks should be made in the houses. Fourth, rivers and lakes should not be used for bathing or washing as it contaminates water. And fifth, domestic sewage and industrial waste should be treated before discharging them into drains. Third pollution is soil pollution. Like water and air, soil is also equally important for living organisms. It supports plant on which all other living organisms depend. The process of soil formation is so slow that the soil may be regarded as a non-renewable source. Therefore, the study and control of soil pollution is important. Any substance that reduces soil productivity is called soil pollutant. And what are the sources of soil pollution? There are several materials which adversely affect physical, chemical, and biological properties of the soil and thus reduce its productivity. These are, first, chemical present in industrial wastes, second, pesticides and insecticides that are sprayed on crops, and third, fertilizers and manures that are added to the soil to increase the crop yields. Now to study effect of soil pollutants. Chemicals and pesticides affect the structure and fertility of soil by killing the soil microorganisms. Pesticides are absorbed by the plants and then transferred to other organisms. Hence, they affected food chains and food webs. Excretory products of livestock and human beings used as manure, which pollute the soil besides giving the high yield. The faulty sanitation and unhygienic practices of the people add to the soil pollution. Pathogens present in the wastes and excreta contaminate the soil and vegetable crops, causing diseases in human and the domesticated animals. Types of soil pollution. First one is positive soil pollution. Reduction in the productivity of soil due to the addition of undesirable substances like pesticides, herbicides, fertilizers, etc. is called positive pollution. These pollutants have a cumulative effect and kill the soil organisms. Second is negative soil pollution. It is caused by the removal of useful components from soil by erosion, deforestation, and improper methods of agriculture. Here to study control of soil pollution. Various measures to control soil pollution are: first one, transfer stations for bulk shifting of refuse should be constructed in cities and big towns. Second, pneumatic pipes should be laid for collecting and disposing wastes. Third, materials like paper, glass, and plastics can be recycled. Fourth, metals should be recovered from scrap and disposed materials. Fifth, use of chemical fertilizers should be reduced by the use of biofertilizers and manures. And sixth, use of pesticides can be reduced by adopting biological control of pests. And seventh, use of cattle dung and agricultural waste in biogas plant should be encouraged. And eighth, deforestation can check soil erosion to a great extent. Fourth type of pollution is noise pollution. Noise pollution can be defined as unwanted or unpleasant sound. So noise pollution is unwanted sound dumped into the atmosphere without regard to the adverse effect it may have. Lack of towns planning had led to residential, commercial, and industrial areas being mixed up. Houses, schools, and hospitals are situated near industries. All the boons of industrialization and civilization, such as motors, horns, heavy and light machinery, work and movement, blaring radios, supersonic aeroplanes, have become disturbing and irritant. Our ear can hear ordinary conversation between 30 to 60 decibels. Modern conversations has a noise value of 60 decibels. A decibel value greater than 80 decibels causes noise pollution. Noise becomes troublesome above 140 decibels. What are the effects of noise pollution? First one is constant noise affects a man physically and mentally. Physical effects include blood vessels to contract, skin to become pale, muscles to constrict and rise in blood pressure, leading to tension and nervousness. Second, high intensity sound emitted by industrial plants, bottling machines, supersonic aircrafts, when continued for long periods of time, not only disturbs but also permanently damage hearing. Third, offices, industries, and crowded places where constant noise prevails can produce temper, tantrums, headaches, fatigues, and nausea. Fourth, loud and sudden noise affect the brain. Intermittent noise leads higher incidence of psychiatric illness and also a danger to health of pregnant mothers and small infants. Fifth, noise has harmful effects on non-living materials also, like cracks develop under the stress of explosive sounds. Now to study control of noise pollution. There are following methods about which we can control noise pollution. First one is limited use of loudspeakers and amplifiers. Second, excursing control over noise producing vehicles. Third, industrial workers should be provided with earplugs. Fourth, delocalization of noisy industries far away from dwelling units. Fifth, within a radius of 10 miles of airport, no buildings or factories should be allowed. Sixth, plants and trees should be planted all around the hospitals, libraries, schools and colleges. And seventh, personal protection against noise can be taken by using cotton plugs in the ear. Fifth type of pollution is radiation pollution. The radiations from the atomic blasts cause several health hazards. The radiations carry high energy and remove electrons from atoms and attach them to other atoms, producing positive and negative ion pairs. Hence, they are known as ionizing radiations. The ionization property of these radiations proves to be highly injurious to the protoplasm. The ionizing radiations of ecological concerns are classified as below. First one is alpha particles, second is beta particles, third is electromagnetic radiations, fourth is neutrons, fifth is X-rays, and sixth is cosmic rays. So all these rays are playing role in radiation pollution. Now to study control of radiation pollution. Following measures can help in controlling the radioactive pollution. Like first is, workers in nuclear plants should be provided with nuclear gadgets and safety measures against accidents. Second, leakage of radioactive elements from nuclear reactors, laboratories, transport, careless handling and use of radioactive fuel should be checked. Third, level of radiation pollution should be monitored regularly in risky areas. And fourth, disposal of radioactive wastes deserves special attention. Sixth type of pollution is marine pollution. All river drainage ends up in seas. On the way to sea, rivers carry large amounts of sewage, garbage, and agriculture discharge, biocides including heavy metals. Besides the discharge of oils and petroleum products, and dumping of radionuclides waste into sea also cause marine pollution. Huge quantity of plastic is being added to sea and oceans. Many marine birds ingest plastics that causes gastrointestinal disorders. The chemical principles in PCBs causes more damage as thinning of egg cells and tissue damage of eggs. Radionuclide waste in sea includes SR90, CS137, PU239 and PU240. In marine water, the most serious pollutant is oil. A spill of oil or petroleum products due to accidents or deliberate discharge of oil polluted waste brings about pollution. Oil pollution causes damage to marine fauna and flora including algae, fish, birds and invertebrates. The oil is soaked in feathers, displacing the air and thus interfaces with buoyancy and maintenance of body temperature. Hydrocarbons and benzoprene accumulates in food chain and consumption of fish by man may cause cancer. Detergents used to clean up the spills are also harmful to marine life. Seventh type of pollution is thermal pollution. The increase in water temperature by industrial units such as steel and iron factories, electric powerhouses and atomic power plants may be called as thermal pollution. Some of the industries generate their own power supply where water is used to cool the generators. This hot water is released into the mainstream, causing a warming trend of surface waters. If the drainage is poorly flushed, a permanent increase in the temperature may result. Many organisms are killed instantly by the hot water resulting into the high mortality. It may bring other disturbances in the ecosystem. The eggs of fish may hatch early or fail to hatch at all. It may change the diurnal and seasonal behavior and metabolic responses of organisms. It may lead to unplanned migration of aquatic animals. Macrophagic population may also be changed. As temperature is an important limiting factor, serious changes may be brought about even by a slight increase in temperature in a population. So this presentation was all about environmental pollution. Hope this presentation will be very, very helpful to all of you. Thanks for kind attention. I have given your my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Shrivastav. Having request, please visit the channel, subscribe it and provide your kind and valuable feedback for further improvements. Thank you.